Margaret, I know that you have relationships with many that work at OpenAI. They are your industry peers, but you have direct relationships. I'd just like to first invite you to give your overall thoughts of what is happening at OpenAI HQ about 3 miles from where I'm sitting.
Right. Yeah. So I think I have a sort of different perspective than a lot of people, although your recent interviews are sort of hitting on them, where I don't know that it's the case that the board has failed broadly. I do think they failed the employees because of this creation of shock and trauma. And what we're seeing is a response based on that, right? When you have the rug pulled out from you, you just want to get the rug back. So that is happening, and that can arguably be a failure of the board. But I think broadly, the board is sticking to some of its original goals, which is to balance the profit and the nonprofit, make sure that safety concerns are being taken seriously, and even making the decision to lose profit in cases where some of the safety concerns are starting to become overwhelming.
I think if one goes openly to OpenAI's website and looks at its governance and the statements it makes it abundantly clear that they put safety ahead of profits. And a not-for-profit governance board, in hindsight, perhaps for VCs, wasn't totally aligned. Has the discussion point change longer term here, Margaret? Do you think that people start to say, okay, well, we have to put the safety to one side because we need to keep on building and founders need to keep on doing deals and the compute power is so expensive?
Yeah, I mean, I think that there will definitely be some changes and updates to this kind of structure. The capped profit model that OpenAI was spearheading was more of an experiment. And with experiments in general, with AI and in science, you just update based on the results you're getting. And so I think we're seeing that here. We'll probably see changes in light of the fact that there clearly is a need to have a reliance on commercial interests, companies like Microsoft to provide compute. And so you don't want to surprise Satya, right, if you have this kind of dependency. So there probably will be some updates here, but I do think that the board, as originally constructed, is basically doing what it's supposed to be doing.
Margaret, how do we find a middle ground if this existential threat issue is the issue? And frankly, we don't know why the board fired Sam Altman. How do you appease both sides?
Actually, if you work towards the solutions, if you sort of take what the issue is and then work backwards towards the solutions, you'll find that the solutions for safety, for existential risk, for bias issues, non-discrimination, a lot of these sort of ethical values that a lot of tech companies are holding right now, the solutions end up being roughly the same, as far as I can tell. And so really the middle ground is, Let's go back to what the solutions are for all these issues that we're thinking and seeing. And can we agree on these solutions, even if our goals are somewhat different? And I think that will really be a place where across the industry we'll see alignment.